Before we move on from panic disorder, I want to use it as a bit of an example to talk in a bit more depth about comorbidity. Now, comorbidity is simply where a person meets criteria simultaneously for more than one diagnosis. For example, your primary or most impairing diagnosis might be panic disorder, but you might also meet criteria for major depressive disorder and a substance use disorder. Comorbidity does not just apply to panic disorder or even just to the anxiety disorders. We see the possibility of comorbidity with any kind of mental illness. Taking panic disorder as our example though, the kinds of presentations that are most commonly comorbid with this particular diagnosis are depressive disorders, other anxiety disorders, and substance use disorders. Depending on the study you look at, somewhere between 10 and 65% of people with a primary diagnosis of panic disorder will also meet criteria for major depressive disorder. Interestingly, in most of these cases, the major depressive disorder develops either around about the same time or subsequent to the panic disorder. Let's think about the co-occurrence of panic disorder and substance use problems for a moment. Why would people with panic disorder, or any number of anxiety disorders for that matter, be using more illicit drugs and alcohol compared to the general population? One of the reasons is that people are essentially using substances to self-medicate or to try and reduce the distress and interference caused by their anxiety symptoms. This use of substances, both legal and illegal, to deal with anxiety is a very common phenomenon in Western nations. We even have an expression, Dutch courage, where we are referring to the courage gained through intoxication with alcohol to face up to feared situations.